Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I wanted to do a little feedback about my experience in EF Shanghai. For the ones who don't know, I've been in EF between the 28th of May to the 3rd of August, so 3 months, and I waited a bit before doing that feedback because I really wanted to make my mind clear and what I really wanted to say, what was positive for me, what was negative there, and I really wanted to make it clear after a while, so I've waited a bit, and now here we go, I will do that feedback. So as I said, I stayed 3 months in Shanghai for learning Chinese, and that was the main reason why I went there. It wasn't really to visit China, it wasn't really to visit Shanghai or to discover Chinese culture, it was really to improve my Chinese. Why did I want to improve my Chinese? Because in September, I would have started my university in Taiwan, which is a national Taiwan university, and now I'm here at the National Taiwan University, but I really wanted to have these basics of Chinese Mandarin before going to Taiwan. And that's why I've spent 3 months in Shanghai. So I arrived in China 2 days before the starting of my EF course. You have to know that every EF classes start on a Monday, so I arrived on a Saturday and the 28th was a Monday and I started my classes. So what was the first negative point, I would say, was not because of EF Shanghai, was maybe because of EF in France. Because when I wanted to leave, like some days before, I didn't know anything. I didn't know if I had a schedule, I didn't know what time I would have to go to school on the Monday, and there was also a problem with my flight because I had received a mail from the director in EF asking me for my return flight. And I was asking, why do you need a return flight? And actually they needed it because they thought I wanted to have a taxi returning me from my home there to the airport. Well, my request, and I paid $60 for that, was to have a taxi from the airport to my house on the day of arrivals, on the 26th of May. And so I had to call EF France before leaving, of course, like 1 or 2 days before, saying, hey, what was the mistake here? Like, I asked for a taxi taking me from the airport to my home and not for the return. And they said that, yes, they did a mistake, and that's it, the mistake was resolved. And also they told me that, of course, I would have my schedule when I arrived on the Monday, and I had to arrive there at 9 a.m. if I remember correctly. But you see these little details that make a difference, because I didn't know the time of arriving, that's like the basic, telling me what time I should arrive. And also like this problem with the taxi thing, imagine I would have missed that email and I would have arrived in Shanghai and there was no one waiting for me in a country I don't speak any language, and I wouldn't have that contact, so like on a Saturday, I don't know who would have answered to me. And it would have been a big problem because I had messed my luggage, I didn't know where to go, etc. But I'd say that's only details and that's not the main part of my video. So on the Monday I arrive there, I do a placement test to have my level of Chinese, and I arrive in a group, let's say, but I asked after like 1, 2 or 3 days to change group and to go lower. Why? Because that group was like super more advanced than my level, but in the meantime it wasn't that difficult neither, because the group lower was like the beginner group and there was only one student. So I was like, either I go and do again all the basics like my name, where I'm from and so on, or I stay in that group where I'm a bit lost and there are also many people, like there were 8 and the other there were only one, there was only one guy. So I said, okay, we'll be 2 students with that teacher, and like that, okay, it will be more personal maybe and the teacher will have more time for us. But yeah, there was not my level, let's say, and it was not like my level, but it's like that. When you arrive, you have to know that you won't have like the perfect level for your level of language, because simply it's not possible. You have either you're a beginner and then it's your perfect level. Either like you also have a level and then either you're in a bit more difficult or a bit lower group. And all my problem towards these 10 weeks I had there is like the level of my class was always a bit lower than what I knew, so I was always a bit lower, and I didn't have this feeling of really improving a lot, or at least the maximum I could. But I still improved a lot and the quality of the classes were really excellent, the teachers were excellent, and if you're afraid of having a bad experience with the teachers, well, let me tell you that they are really really qualified, really good teachers that I really enjoy to have classes with, and that's for sure. But the problem was simply the level of the classes. And another problem is that starting from July, a lot of people came and left, because it was the season where everyone is in holiday, so a lot of people just come and go. So my class was a bit like, oh, some people come 2 weeks and then they leave, go 2 weeks and then they leave. So the teacher had to explain again and again everything, kind of, because they were not beginners who were coming, but they were not at the level we had arrived. So all the time she had to explain again, again, again the same things, and I stayed 10 weeks with the same teacher. So some things I knew by heart, you know, and that was kind of annoying to always feel that you have to pull the others, that you don't really improve, and that was like my biggest problem. Like, I always felt that the classes were good, really good, excellent, but it was never my perfect level. My perfect level was actually between that group and the highest group, so I was always in between, you know. But it's alright, it's okay, it's like that. But I kind of had time to do other things, let's say. I loved the activities proposed by EF. There were a lot of free activities, but also not free activities. And not free activities, like, I've done some, others I didn't go to because they, maybe I was not interested, maybe like it was maybe too expensive, but some things were less expensive than the random price. For instance, we did a Hangpu River cruise, and that cruise was 120 RMB, so the currency in China, and we paid it 100 because it was a group ticket, and our activity manager was super nice and she made it cheaper for us, and she always tries to make things kind of cheap for us, which was super good. And I've enjoyed a lot of these activities like karaoke, KTV, and that was the good part of EF, knowing that you don't only go for classes. What you have to understand is like you go to live an EF experience, and not like EF as a language class. You really go to live the experience, so meeting people from all other countries, from all around the world, from Europe a lot too, but like from the US, from Brazil, from Mexico, from Japan, a lot of people from everywhere in the world, talking with them, being friends with them, understanding them. That was super, super interesting. That was super interesting too. So it's not like really just to live the experience of language, it's really to live the whole experience of EF. And we were talking a bit about the summer, and the fact that there were a lot of people coming during the summer, and actually it can be a good and a bad thing. A good because you meet a lot of people, obviously, but also a bad thing, as I said, with all these people coming in the class, and also a lot of people you don't have time to discover. So yeah, that was kind of, you know, kind of not super good. And also the problem is that a lot of people come in the summer to have fun. So it was kind of a difference between the ones who really just go to have fun, to nightclubs in Shanghai, and the others who wanted to study. I was in between. I was between the ones who kind of more want to study but also to have fun, and I've done vlogs in French about my experience of, I don't know, nightclubs or just experiences of activities. So yeah, a lot of people just went there to just be hangover all the time, to be drunk all the time, and that was kind of, you know, a bit difficult sometimes, because you always are with these people, so you always hear, oh, I've been to that club, and they pull you to go to these clubs. And I've been quite a lot to clubs, let's say, even if it was not why I want to EF, you know, I want there to study Chinese. But at the same time, it's the EF experience too. You meet people, you meet young people, so you go to these activities too. And it was the summer, it was hot. You know, it's the moment when you enjoy a bit your life too. So you have to know that if you go to EF, you will have to, in EF Shanghai, at least this part of EF exists too, like the parties and so on, and maybe you're not prepared for it, or at least you don't know about it, so I'm telling you about it. And you have to know about that. You have to know that it's not only studying, and EF is not at all only about studying. We have 3 hours a day plus 1.5 hours of spin class. Spin class is like the option that you choose. It's either like Chinese in business, or grammar Chinese, or Chinese in movies. And we have also a lecture which is like 1.5 hours per week, and this lecture is like a big lecture about a big course about, let's say, I don't know, a region of China, or a game in China, or a movie, or a tradition. And these were interesting sometimes not, it depends on the subject. And also the thing is, it's mainly in Chinese with some English words, but It depends on the level that you understand it, because everyone is mixed for this lecture class. So the ones who are really advanced, they understand. The ones who are really beginners, they don't. They're just bored because they don't get anything except for the images. So it really depends on people. So yeah, you have to know that if you go to EF, you don't just go for learning the language, but you go also to live the experience. And also, yeah, you go there and you pay for the classes, for the activities, like to enjoy these activities, and you also pay for the security. Like for instance, if you want a weekend to visit China, Shanghai, or whatever country you are in or city, well, you know that you have this EF insurance or security, let's say. Like if you lose yourself, if someone steals you or whatever, you always have a phone number you can call at any time and say, okay, now I have a trouble, I'm lost in the middle of the street, it's night, I'm alone. Or if you have an accident, you know that someone will come to the hospital to see if you're okay. So you have this, you know, EF insurance, not insurance, but like security, that you're not alone in that country or city. And I think that's also a part why you pay EF, and I think that's important. So all in all, I really enjoyed my experience in EF. I really would like to go there, and when I was there, I was always like, oh, I want to go there again, it would be so nice to live again and meeting all these people, because that's super interesting. Now I have friends that I met there and I'm always talking with them, you know. I'm still like, oh, how are you? And they're from the other side of the world, you know, and we're just like, we would have never known about each other without this experience in EF. And first of all, I went really to EF to really learn Chinese, as I said, but I discovered a lot more than I expected, and I maybe learned a bit less than I expected, but maybe I learned a lot of other things, you know what I mean. So yeah, you have to know that. You have to know that EF, you pay not only for the classes, even if the classes are high quality, as I said, if you find your perfect group level, which is kind of difficult also, because as I said, in the summer, maybe we are 16 in the class, so it's difficult, but maybe in September or the periods when I arrived in May, June, we were only two in the class. So it depends also in the period of the year where you go. And also, I recommend you not to go in the summer, maybe, because it's more expensive and there are more people, so it's less good, and you're more easily distracted by all these activities and all the people. But it depends what you really search for, you know, what you really want from this experience. So yeah, thank you a lot for watching that video, guys. If you have any questions, let me know. I have now a EF ambassador page. You can go and check that out in the description below. That means that you can just order a brochure from EF and just decide if you want to go in a EF country. I think I would go again to EF, maybe to EF Shanghai at least, because I don't need to improve my English level. But maybe for Chinese and maybe for other languages, it's something I would consider, really, because I really enjoyed my experience. But again, I would maybe do things a bit differently with the period of the year where I would go, and also with knowing more how to organize myself, in the sense like, okay, I know that in summer, for instance, like there are more people going to parties, so maybe go in September and more work on my classes, or decide more what I really search from that experience, so now I have more knowledge about it. So yeah, you can download this brochure, it's free, and it really helped me a lot before planning my trip to Shanghai. And yeah, as I said, I can just recommend you to go there, because as you may have seen with all my vlogs, I think I really enjoyed my experience in EF. So thank you a lot for watching that video, guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.